doing some shoulder out warm up.
That's kind of our standard, we do it at walk, track, canter, he needs to canter a little bit. His thing is he tends, when he's tight, he does this kind of stuff, which is why we do the like yoga.
Okay, so what I want you to do, I call it the drunk trotting, the drunk walking. I want you to come up quarter line, and I want you to move your shoulders across the quarter of the line, right? So make a little leg heel right, little leg heel left. If he flings his head, take your hands apart and pressure down. So widen the snaffle rings and push downward. And then when you soften, take your hands back to their normal position. Good. Think of moving your shoulders from side to side.
You can keep it behind at the same place.
Yes. Your idea is not to deviate the hind quarters, the idea is to deviate the shoulders from one side of the snaffle to the other. So not just flexing, moving your shoulders. Now that's moving his haunches. So think of his head lower, go to the walk for a minute. Now so pick your straight line. Now move your shoulders off your left leg. There, now move your shoulders off your right leg. Good, now move your shoulders off your left leg. So we should change flexion when you move your shoulders off your leg. So when you move off the left leg, you should flex left, open your right hand, begin to flex. Now exaggerate that. Make the line, make the chain bend longer, and more exaggerate. Opening the outside rein, moving your shoulders through the space. Stay connected down through your seatbelt. Bigger and more attachment. So whatever you can offer that, I can agree, honestly, that's the left leg. Left leg. Open right rein, kick it through the hole. There you go. Now sink down your back. Don't reflect that tension on your shoulder.
Teria stopped and started it.
Good. Open the right rein.
After you were done.
There you go. Put your foot under his left elbow. There you go. Your left leg into your back leg.
that.
It'll be a while, because I'll just wait till she's ready.
Yeah, you have the
There. Good. Leg yielding to the T. Leo, come on, get an offer last night. Wave down the elbow. There you go. That's it. Now quiet your hands down. Yeah, drag your body. Yeah, okay. That's the left leg. Good. Hands down. Good. Now reach back with those three long legs. Hands down. Pressure downward. Get the front of your saddle. Good. Now soften. Your goal is not to hold his face. There you go. Nice job. Now pull your knees down. And if you're going to canter, you must be leg-yielding to it. And through it. Hands down. We're climbing. Yeah. Yes. Good job.
I can do it. I'll do it.
All right.
I have sympathy for your back.
Appreciate that. It's finally getting better.
Off the ground. Now, pushing the contact, so you're opening your feet.
Where's the hay?
Hands go forward, legs close
in. What hay he gets.
Pulling back on the inside rein, you're going to stall the inside line of breath. So you want, what you're looking for is in connecting up to the outside rein more, right? So sink down that right seat bone, don't pull hard on your right rein. Make that right hand come up and pick up your outside rein.
Yo, is there your mama? She's gonna get carried. Feeling you?
Now it's enough in front of your leg. If I said canter, you can get a on a runway for a reason. Outside hand has to stay down on the outside of his neck, and the left leg has to be a little more convincing without the left hand facing it, without the right hand creeping across the neck. Yeah? So all through. Drag your bucket, slow your head, and get in front of your head. This so I want to see this. Good. Now close your leg and ask him to step up. That's your bridge moment in yoga, right? So don't hard your hands, don't retract your hands. Sit down and lift the horse, close your leg and push him around a little bit. There's what's the call of design feet. Feel the difference? Yeah, super. Slow your hip again, don't rush. Stay on the feet, don't lock your hands. Wrists are downward, bridge moment in yoga, shoulders forward, right? Push your hips forward. There you go. Now we can leg going out to the canter. Left leg doesn't fall. line in first. That's beat one. The diagonal here is beat two. The leading four line is beat three. Right? The horse is most all line quarters in beat one. Most on the forehand in beat three.
Yes.
Right? So one, two, three. Hind legs go up in the air. Come forward. Repeat. Right? Wash them to beat. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. When riders go up a hill, do they lean forward or backwards?
Sorry, when they go
up a hill?
Lean forward.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Down, lean back. Yeah. Right? So the rider's natural inclination as the horse is cantering on the haunches on the forehand is they might go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Right? And the top sweep the saddle, follow the motion, right? So that's great. We want to minimize the time on the forehand, and we want to encourage flexion of the joints of the hind leg and get the horse to jump under and sit on the first beat. Okay? So in that moment, one, two, tighten the abdominal muscles and sit down. Close your eye. Right? So we're going to minimize the amount of time the horse wants to spend on the forehand. We're going to minimize the time that the horse turns to creep up in the air. So picture your typical quarter horse era. Doesn't bend its hind legs to canter, right?
Yeah.
So it kind of goes.
Yeah.
Right? So it has to pop its butt up in the air to swing the pendulum forward, right? So we want to say no to one who's trying to bend, so maybe we can put a lid on top of the group. So it's one, two, abs, sit, legs on three. So it's one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. So it's two, two. Two. Not open here, but it is stopping the swing, the natural tendency swing of the lap. So when you're ready, we're going to try that. We should try to do it.
Yeah, we'll try right first.
We're forward the inside.
You have one bad habit.
All right? So, put more in front of the leg. Don't chase with your hips. And then think of bringing in more out to the connection. Sink, drag your bucket, close the leg, push it out. Hands are down, wrists are down. No awkward action in the wrist. That's a walk and base of that. Wrist downward, pushing outward. Okay, think of turning your back in this direction. Show me your back.
This way.
Stopping your hip and tighten your abs and close your legs instead. Good. See the difference in the canter?
Yeah.
Good. Now, looking off the ground, you're sitting in down more on the third beat where he has to sit and flex the hind legs a little. Pull harder on his neck. Sit stronger in your back. There. Now, don't chase the front end. Just canter the two front feet. Was a little softer. Sit down a little stronger. Tighten your hamstrings, tighten your hip, and close your back. Don't pull more on your neck. Sit stronger in your back. There. Use your posterior half, glutes, hamstrings, calves. Stop your leg. Stop the progression and sit down instead. There you go. Tendency to pull your legs back, so that you're showing your back a little more straight. So, yeah, let your right hip open, let your right knee and this right side descend a little more into the pocket. Good. Okay, so, right hand inside arm down.
just like my weak leg?
Yes. Yes. I usually do my other my weak leg pain.
It's right on the horse.
It's sort of like a routine to win. They're like, hey, you got a better job. So here's a little bit, now you have to negotiate a little bit, right? Because you agreed to something. Now you're saying, no, I don't really need this to actually work. So go your right side a little back. Don't let your leg fall. So instead of reacting to your left leg by doing this, he's reacting to your left leg by doing this. Okay? We want him to react here. Move your shoulders to my right knee. That's all you're asking for.
So can I think like move his shoulders to the outside of the circle?
Yes, but I don't want you doing it by deviating sideways. So that's still your right hand doing everything. Your right hand is not the boss of your right. It's the back that is not responding to the front of the head, masking all those other things. So move his shoulders to the bigger circle. Not his hindquarters inward, not changing flexion, not changing bending. side.
And that's when we're in a shoulder in. He gets back there.
Yeah, it's the side of the hip. So if you work over the outside, it's in.
That's my ball.
Correct. Your brain is circle.
Okay.
So spirograph. So there's a circle. And then there's a series of circles, right? That exists in a potential circle of shoulder. If you were to take a shoulder hip step in the position you are right now without reorienting to the pillar, would you be facing the pillar or to the left of the pillar? Now, if I said to a shoulder hip right now, where would you be? Would you be to the left of the pillar?
Oh,
wait, if I change it, I'd be to the left. Correct. So with each subsequent sequence of the stride, you have to think pivot and reorient back to the pillar. Right. Now, did you hear me talking to Terry about rain back?
I did. Oh, yes. Yes.
Okay. So rain back has to be the ability of the rider to influence weight coming off the front legs while in forward motion.
Yeah.
So here's a great way to experiment with that.
Yeah.
And we have an exercise called the rain back on. So I call it the rain back on collection. Rain back on.
Okay.
Right? So it functions a bit like common canada. It's the same idea of I can draw the weight off the front leg and get it to rock back into the outside line. So if the horse is invading the pillar, right, it's getting too close, I want to think rein back as I'm in shoulder and back out to the original circle line and then come around the pillar again. Right?
Mm-hmm.
We do this at walk, trot, and canter.
This is a good working activity. This is working
activity. This is classic. So you want to think of clicking and orienting yourself, so you line up with the pillar. So you line up with the pillar.
Forehead.
So you line up with the pillar. His forehead is wherever you want. If you want to increase it, you can put those above the line of the pillar, or you can have it at a flatter angle and have it below the line. For you, it's about you clicking to the center. Clicking to the center. Clicking to the center. Where's
start with a circle.
So again, he's a small person, we can start with the very small. He's familiar with this exercise from his working meditation anyway. This should be about a 10-minute circle. You can make it a little tight. So establish your original circle and then start to pivot into shoulder and arm. Thinking about where is the center of bend versus the center of rotation. But the steeper you make it, the more difficult it is on the horse.
Am I making it too steep?
No. Oh no, I practice this exercise with the nose on the other side of the cone. That's how steep I'm working. Right? So this is fairly shallow.
Dead leg.
We're doing something?
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah. Okay, we know where.
Absolutely.
She's a wild beast. Nobody believes me when I say she's a wild beast.
She was, I don't know what did it, but she like...
So remember I said when I